Dear parents and teachers, have you ever felt that your students or your child don't follow your instruction clearly? If you have experienced that, then no problem. I had also experienced the same thing. But we can follow these three rules while instructing our students or our kids. So the rule number one for instruction is give one instruction at a time. Our brain can process one instruction at a time. When we instruct our students or kids, let them complete that task first and then give them another instruction. If we keep on instructing them, they will not be able to understand and process the instruction, or they will not be able to take action for that particular instruction. So this is rule number one, give one instruction at a time. Let them complete that work and then you can give them another instruction. Rule number two, always instruct in a positive manner. What do I mean positive manner? Most of the time we do this mistake, and I have also done these mistakes many times, that we instruct that don't do this, don't go there, or don't behave like this. So when we say don't do this, don't behave like this, exactly what is happening? When we give instruction to student or kids, they actually create image in their mind related to that instruction. And when we say don't go there, they create the image of going there. When we say don't sit like this, they create image of sitting like this. So try to avoid these instructions starting with don't do or don't. Rather than, in our instruction, we can give them the picture of what they need to do, like go there or sit like this, eat like this. What will happen? Our instructions will help them to create the image. So whatever instruction we give, as a positive statement or as a negative statement, anyways they create image. So what we have to take care of, we have to give them image which we want them to act on. Your instruction must contain the clear picture of the action you want your child to do. Okay, so as I give you the example, do this. So they will get clear picture, sit like this. So give them clear picture of how they need to sit, rather than don't sit like this. That was rule number two. And rule number three is, most of the time in family, mother is giving instruction, father is giving instruction, grandmother is giving instruction, grandfather is giving instruction. So many people give them instruction at a time. And I think we need to avoid that, because every child can process one instruction at a time. So if you give them instruction from multiple ways, then they will not be able to execute a single one. So I think we as a parent and teacher can follow these three rules for instructions. What do you think? Out of 10 times, if you can manage to do this at least 6 or 7 times, and that will help our child to improve their performance. What do you think? If you agree with this, just try and apply this and let me know your experience in comment box. Thank you so much. This is Shubhada Bhave, teacher, trainer, entrepreneur and parent.